Ladies and gentlemen, beloved brothers and sisters in Christ, dear friends, this is Brother Frank speaking to you from the International Mission Center in Krefeld, Germany. It's always a privilege for me to share with you the precious Word of God. You might have realized we do not interpret Scripture. We believe God's Word the way it is written. And as Brother Branham, the man sent from God in our time, used to say, God is His own interpreter. First, the Lord of glory makes promises, and then, when the time comes, He fulfills what He promised. It's good to know that the New Testament starts with the fulfillment of promises and prophecies from the Old Testament. And it's also good to know that the New Testament ends in the same way. Bible prophecies are being fulfilled in our time. And the Lord Himself said in Matthew 24, when you see all these things come to pass, then you know it's near, even at the door. In Luke 21, our Lord makes even a stronger statement and says, when you see all these things come to pass, look up, for your redemption is drawing near. Beloved, I'm not here to scare you. I'm just here to warn you. I preach God's word, not to please men, but to please God, but to help men, to help you, beloved brothers and sisters, to understand the time we're living in, to understand the part of God's plan of salvation for our time. As already mentioned, the New Testament began with the fulfillment of promises and prophecies. John the Baptist was a promised prophet, Isaiah chapter 40, verse 3. Malachi 3, verse 1, confirmed in the New Testament, in Matthew, in Mark, in Luke, in John, and especially in Mark chapter 1, these two prophecies from the Old Testament are mentioned in the first three verses. Then Jesus Christ was the promised Messiah, the promised prophet, the promised Redeemer, and all Scripture pertaining to His coming was fulfilled and were fulfilled when He came. In fact, if you go to Matthew chapter 1, you can start with the first chapter and then see how it was emphasized about the fulfillment of Scripture. Matthew chapter 1, verse 22. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, fulfillment, fulfillment, fulfillment of Bible promises and scriptural predictions at the first coming of Christ. Most certainly, we do live now very, very close to the return of Christ. This is not only the end time, it is the end of the end time. If you look into Scripture, then the last days are spoken of as a period, as a long period. If you go to Hebrews chapter 1, there we are told that the Lord God has spoken to the prophets and through the prophets to the fathers in the times past. But in these last days, he has spoken unto us by his Son. If you go to Acts chapter 1, again, the term is being used, in the last days, says God, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Acts 2:17. So, the last days, as a long period, started right on the day of Pentecost, started when the Lord came to redeem us, and they will be finished when he returns to take us home to glory. But then we do have specific scriptures that do speak of the last days pertaining to the time we're now living in, not only to the space, to the long space of 2,000 years. If you wish to know about the space of 2,000 years, you again have to go to the prophets in the Old Testament, especially to Hosea chapter 6, verse 1 and 2, pertaining to Israel. The scripture declares, come, let us return unto the Lord, for he has torn and he will heal us. He has smitten and he will bind us up. And then comes the most important statement. After 2 days will he revive us. In the third day he will raise us up and we shall live in his sight. Going to 2 Peter chapter 3, a very important scripture pertaining to the end time and also to the return of our Lord. In the same chapter of 2 Peter 3, we read in verse 3, knowing this first, that there shall come in the last days scoffers, walking after their own lusts, saying, where is the promise of his coming? And then in verse 8, we are told, beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing, that one day is with the Lord as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day. So in prophecy, we have the understanding that one day can be 1,000 years. But then when we come to the actual end time, then we read in the various scriptures, like in 1 Timothy chapter 4 from verse 1, now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of demons, speaking lies in hypocrisy, having their conscience seared with a hot iron, forbidding to marry, and so forth. Well, this is what we have to look at in our day and time. There are so many doctrines which are not in agreement with the Holy Scriptures. And let me tell you this, only what comes from God will take us back to God. The Word originates with God, and the Word takes us back to God. Every interpretation originates with the enemy and will place us under the influence of the enemy. Therefore, I repeat, William Branham, God's servant and prophet, said, God is his own interpreter. Then, if we go to 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 1, we read, this know also that in the last days perilous times shall come. And then the whole description is given of how things would be in homes, in families, in general. The whole situation in the end time is described to the details. Beloved, my ministry should be apostolic. It should be prophetic. If I say apostolic, it must agree in every point 100% with the teachings of the apostles. Like it says in Acts chapter 15, verse 15, and to this agree the words of the prophets, as it is written. Here, the apostle James was speaking about the things pertaining to the Jews and also to the Gentiles, and how God first would take a people for his name from the nations and then turn to Israel. Beloved, the time has come to speak freely and openly to you. The main promise that should come to pass and be fulfilled before the return of Christ is found in Malachi chapter 4, the last verses. And this I should say in every sermon I preach around the world. You might wish to know why I emphasize the promise for this day. Beloved brothers and sisters, if we don't believe the promises God made in his word in general, for all times during the space of grace, that's one thing. But then when it comes to the point, we have to have more than just a general belief, and then continue in the general belief as we wish. And we go into all the movements, and especially to the last revival waves, which started after World War II in 1946, when Brother Branham received the direct divine commission on May the 7th. We could even go back to the turn of the century, 100 years ago, when the outpouring of the Holy Spirit took place and the last move of God came about. Everybody knows about the outpouring of the Holy Spirit in Azusa Street. Everybody knows the most famous names of that revival, be it in Britain or in the United States or other countries. And then again, the question arises, did those who had part in this great revival 100 years ago, did they realize what God did 50 years ago? And then again, we have to ask today, do those who live today realize what God is doing now? Or do they only look back to what God has done in the 1940s, in 1950s up to 1965, when it took Brother Branham home to glory. Beloved, it is so important to know what God is doing right now. And let me tell you, with divine authority placed and originating with the Word of God, this is God's time for God's people to have part in the calling out, in the correction, in the restoration, returning to the Word of God, returning to the same power, to the same teachings and practices of the apostles. Beloved, God will never agree with us. We shall have to agree with God. And then again, we realize what the Apostle Paul was writing to the Corinthian church, that the natural man does not receive the things of the Spirit. And before you can receive the things of the Spirit, you must be born by the Spirit. You must be filled with the Spirit. You must be anointed, and you must be led by the Holy Spirit. We have many movements which try to move the Holy Spirit. Now we need a movement that is moved by the Holy Spirit, moving us back into the presence of Almighty God, moving us back into the book of Acts, moving us out of all traditions, of all wrong teachings and practices, and taking us back to the original teachings and practices of the Word of God. Beloved, it was William Branham who, by a divine commission, received the charge to bring unto us the message containing the Word of God in its fullness. He was not a man of the interpretations. He was a man of the original words of God. Prophets don't have interpretations. Theologians have many interpretations. But a prophet has the Word of God. A prophet has it, thus says the Lord. And the true prophet will not start a new religion. He will not bring about a new church. He will bring us back to the original, so that Jesus Christ, who purchased the church, who paid the price, can build the church, and then the gates of hell shall not prevail against her. So this is God's time. And let me tell you very clearly, William Branham was told, as John the Baptist was sent to forerun the first coming of Christ, you are sent with the message which will forerun the second coming of Christ. So, in December 1965, the Lord took William Branham, his servant, home to glory. But only after he was taken to glory, right in the year 1966, we took the message of God from country to country, from continent to continent, and from city to city, as the Lord had ordained, and according to the divine commission. We just have to take the original teachings to the people of God, wherever they might be. Now, if we look into what happened in recent history, especially in Rome and also in Germany, and then perhaps we need to make a jump 500 years ago and look into church history, it was a German monk whom God used to bring the breakthrough in the days of Reformation. And the Reformation had to be so all the other revivals could follow. If there would have been no breakthrough in the days of Reformation, all the other revivals could not have come. And then again, we understand that Germany and Europe was divided into Catholic and into Protestant countries and areas. Even countries themselves were divided in the Catholic and into a Protestant part, like it was in Germany and Switzerland and many other countries. And then we look after World War II and see that there was again a dividing of the world, of this continent, and also of the country we call Germany. After World War II, Germany was divided, Berlin was divided, Europe was divided. But then, since 1989, Germany was united, Europe was united, the world is being united, everything goes global right now, and the world government is being established, and all religions and all churches unite under Rome. And if you go into the prophetic scriptures, into Daniel 2, Daniel 7, Daniel 8, and then skip to Revelation chapter 13, 17, and 18. If you go to all these chapters, beloved, you have the description of the constellation that will be at the end time. All is being united. The political power, the religious power, the economic power is being united. And beloved, this is the time when the world church is having the world government under her rule. And by the way, you have to understand, I'm not judging, I'm just saying this because it is true. The Roman Church is also a government. The Pope is both the head of state and he is the head of the Roman Church. And the Roman Church state has diplomatic relations with 175 countries on earth. And therefore, the possibility is given all over the earth to bring all together into the unity. But beloved, there is another unity. According to John 17, Father, thou in me, and I in them, that we should be one. Beloved, I want you to be one with Christ in God. I want you to agree with the Word of God. Don't be part in the world organization. Be part of the body of Christ. Be part of what God is doing right now as he fulfills his promises with his people in a most wonderful way. I would just say, if we can serve you more in sending you literature dealing with these important subjects, just let us know. God has given us the privilege and possibility to serve the whole earth. I think now in over 20 main languages on all the 5 continents. And beloved, we wish to be of service to you in the precious name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, and now may His blessings rest upon you. And if I don't see you on earth, I like to see you at the bright full morning when our Lord shall return to take us home. Be blessed in Jesus' holy name. Amen.